Alright, what's for one Vacation Finder here, and today we're gonna be playing, or should I say ranking, some more Akeleng, Afloratua Weapions. Now, I did decide to skip the medic because, I mean, for the medic you just heal pretty much and that's it. I mean, if you guys really want me to do a medic tier list, I can probably squeeze it in. I don't see why not. But today we're just gonna be looking at the Demolitionist. Now, for the demo, I am extremely freaking biased on some weapons because, you know, it is my favorite perk, and let's just go straight into it with the fucking C4. Now, with the C4, this thing is just equipment. Pretty much you just have it as a backup, but personally for me, yeah, there's just not a lot of it. It's just not practical in any way, at least for me. I know a lot of people that actually use C4 a lot, and it is cool for, you know, just like chopping down flesh bones and shit like that, but for me, I use it sometimes, but ultimately it's a C for me, man. Like I said, I'm gonna be biased, so don't hate me here. Okay, now we have the HX25, yep, the starting weapon for the demo. Usually I put starting weapons at D tier because they're usually quite forgettable, but with the HX, it's just like a solid A, man. I mean, it costs pretty much nothing, it kills trash, and if you're a level 25, it's a nuke freaking machine. It also has a lot of ammunition, and I mean, what else is there to say? It's just like a good little backup. Usually you pair this with, you know, any of the, you know, tier 4, tier 5 weapons, and you're gonna be quite solid. Okay, now we got the Blunderbuss. Now, the Blunderbuss, I feel like it's a little bit better on the support, but for the demo, I mean, I'm just gonna put it at C, man. I don't really see a point in using this bad boy on the demo. I mean, it is good, you know, you can still do some, you know, unique takedowns, stuff like that. It's good for nukes. And if you have the other level 25 skill, it's not that bad, but for me, like I said, it's my personal tier list, it's gonna be at C. And speaking of my personal tier list, yep, Kaboomstick, just make your way up to S, please. But yeah, man, Kaboomstick, it's just like an HX25, but you can jump with it, you can jump back, you can jump on top of things, you can do nukes for days. You can take down pretty much anything. Overall, if you ask me, it is a little bit overpowered, but in a good way. I mean, it is killing floor, so. Yep, Kaboomstick, you are directly at the S. Okay, now we got the M32. Yep, this thing is a little bit underwhelming. I mean, if you get like up close and personal to like a Skrake, yeah, you can just like shoot him 6 times, blah blah blah, headshot him, kill him. But why would you use this if you have the RPG? I just don't even know. I mean, I would put this thing in, you know, A tier if it weren't for ghost shells, ghost projectiles on multiplayer. I mean, on solo, it works good, but on multiplayer, yes, sometimes it just doesn't even shoot. I mean, let's say you have like 5 rounds, and only out of those 5 rounds, you only shoot 4. And that's quite, well, yeah, bad for the weapon, so I'm just gonna put it at B. It's not terrible, but at the same time, it is, well, yeah, quite awkward. Especially for the long reload, yeah, I'm probably just gonna put it at C, maybe, later, I guess we'll see. Okay, Seal freaking Squeal. This thing is actually not that bad. If it weren't for the buff, I would put this thing at B. It was still, like, kinda good beforehand, but now, it's actually quite decent. It is good for nukes, crowd control, even taking down flesh bones, maybe Skrakes sometimes. But at the same time, it's actually not that bad. Okay, speaking of not that bad, we got the M16 M203. Some people actually prefer this over the HX or the Kaboomstick, and personally, I don't know why. If you take the game, quote-unquote, seriously, and you don't want to, will you disrupt your sharpshooter or gunslinger on the team? I guess this makes for a more clean kill potential something. But for me, when I play the demo, yeah, I'm just all about the damage and da boom. So I'm just gonna put this in the middle of the road. That's probably where I'm gonna put it. Okay, speaking of middle of the road, yep, the sucker, the Seeker 6. Oh my god, yep, I do see a lot of beginning players playing with this thing, and they do use it mainly on lock-on. Overall, it's not that bad, but it's definitely not S or A for me personally. It is good, but I just personally don't see myself using it at all. Nah. Now, the benefits for this thing is, like I said, lock on. You do have, you know, 6 rounds in the magazine, and it's also faster, you know, reload-wise than the M32. Okay, you know what? I just changed my mind. I think I'm just gonna put the M32 down at C tier because, I don't know, man, it's just not worth having at all. So yeah, Sucker 6, you are pretty much is gonna be at B, and that's where you are. Okay, speaking of middle of the road, now we have the M79. Before the Kaboom Stick, yep, I did play a lot with the M79, but when the Kaboom Stick came, yeah, this thing just became obsolete pretty much. You don't really need it, even in long games, because you got stuff like the HX. So yeah, I know, I'm still probably gonna be using it from time to time, but I'd much rather have this over all of these three, so yeah, go into B. Oh, yo, now we got the Gravity Imploder, fam. Yep, I don't even know where the hell to put this one. Now, it's not bad. It does work, and it has, you know, that knockdown potential, and it's good for crowd control. But it is a heavy weapon, and therefore, hey, it's pretty much forgettable, man, I don't know. But yeah, C tier, it's pretty much forgettable weapons, and D tier is weapons I would probably never pick. And I do believe the demo is one of those perks that you can pretty much use anything and, you know, still be effective as long as you know what the hell you're doing with the demo. But for me personally, C tier, yeah, they're just forgettable weapons. B tier are weapons I use often. A tier is weapons I'm probably gonna be using pretty much in every match. And S tier, pretty much the same as A, but I just like him a little bit more. Oh, yo, speaking of weapons I'm using a lot of the freaking time, the RPG. So yeah, the RPG, I don't think anyone's even gonna question why I'm gonna put this at S tier. I did remember someone actually saying that the Seeker 6 is better than the RPG in every way. I don't know if that dude was trolling or not, but I mean, I don't know, I mean, you just can't beat these two weapons, man, you just can't. Dude, if I'm playing the demo, I usually just go for the Holy Trinity, which is the HX, Kaboom Stick, and RPG. Sometimes I would swap the RPG for the Seeker 6, or maybe sometimes the, what's it called, Seeker 6, but that's about it. Okay, since we're just here, I'm gonna be talking about how I play my Demolitionist. So you do start with an A tier weapon, which is the HX25. Now, I usually just like hold on to this thing until I can get the Kaboom Stick, and I just have these two in pair. And when I get enough for the RPG, yeah, I just like swap the HX for the RPG. And that's pretty much it. I just have these two S tier weapons, and I just, well yeah, steamroll every single game. One would argue that the demo is only fun because of these two weapons, and I might be saying that as well. Well then boys, the last weapon on the list is gonna be the Husk Kanon. Or should I say the Usk Kanon? Now the weapon by itself, it's not terrible, it's pretty much better than all of these in my opinion. But I don't see myself, you know, seeking out to play this weapon, so I'm just gonna put it at B. It is good for nukes and good for, you know, some ground fire from time to time. But ultimately, yep, this is much better on the firebug, which is, I do believe, the next perk we're gonna be checking out. This is pretty much my Demolitionist tier list. I usually just play with, you know, SA weapons for the most part. Sometimes I use B tier weapons, but not often. And C tier weapons, yeah, they're just forgettable, but still work. I mean, maybe the Blunderbuss at B tier, or maybe the Gravity Imploder at B tier, but I don't know, man. I do know a lot of people are gonna say, oh, but put Funder C4 S tier, very good, very boom boom, yes? But it's just not for me, man. But yeah, this is pretty much it. Let me know which weapons you would switch over. And with that being said, hopefully you guys enjoyed. Leave a like, subscribe, and see you guys next episode. Adios.